You know, throughout this journey, I've been pretty much reliving my childhood. Nostalgia everywhere. I'm reliving all the cartoons I grew up loving. Yeah, I don't know how I made it this far without talking about the DC animated universe. Like, that was everything to me. You got Batman the Animated Series, Superman the Animated Series, Batman Beyond, Justice League Unlimited. Yeah, like everything. It was a shared universe before the MCU, and I feel like I'm forgetting one of them. Wait, no. Yeah, I'm definitely forgetting one. This is gonna kill me. Oh, okay. Oh my God. What was? All right, Superhero Static Shock. We'll be doing the DC Animated Universe today, which was huge when I was growing up. Like I said, they had Batman, Superman, Batman Beyond, Justice League, Static Shock. It was a huge deal to see so many of, you know, the most famous heroes in a shared universe, and it was super, like, critically acclaimed. It was written by Paul Dini. And the characters were designed by Bruce Timm. So those are the two names you see most often associated with all of these shows. So today we're going to be doing Bruce Timm style. And I chose Static because, as I said earlier, representation matters. And it was really cool, you know, to see a superhero, a kid, dreadlocks, just fighting crime, like, occasionally alongside Batman and everything. And the character I have here is a black woman. So, he really kind of draws all styles the same. Actually, we're going to be drawing a character looking this way for a change. And like most character designs, we're going to start with this circle. If a previous drawing is showing up on camera right now, that's because, once again, like the Dragon Ball drawing, I had to map it out first, see if I had enough room. And erased it to the best of my ability. If you could do it once, you could do it twice. The big hair is really like the cause of concern. So you got your circle down. Now we're gonna start on the lower jaw. And instead of drawing something sharp, actually we don't have an example. These two are ovals and these two are just, you know, straight on portraits. So you're gonna draw kind of a diagonal curve that's gonna come around. We're gonna do a lot of this out of order because it's jumping around and I'm not too familiar with the Bruce Timm style. I used to draw it as like a little kid, but I haven't returned to it since. So since the head is turned this way, the line that goes straight down isn't gonna be in the middle. It's gonna be about right here where the, on this half of the face where the lower jaw begins. Let's actually draw a line straight up. We're gonna erase this section, but let's have it there for reference so we have somewhere to put the ear. The ear is just round. And unlike what I told you before with the eye line starting, you know, where the ear meets the head, I'm gonna draw it down here for this style. And that's where the middle line, the curved middle line, is gonna stop in the first section. I'm gonna come out and then go to the chin. Now, immediately, before you go into detail, well, actually, let's get a neck here first. I'm Now, as I was saying, before you go into detail, you want to notice like the shaping of everything. So right here, I'm liking this jaw. The cheek over here, though, shouldn't be lower. It should be higher. So you can fix that just by changing the curve, changing the diagonal. Turn is going to make it look sleeker, like it doesn't come out as much. And erase, so when you work on it later, you won't get confused. I like the shape of that much better. Looks more like a human face. You can have this curvy, sharp. It depends on your character, that's up to you. So, we're gonna move on to the eyes. And I probably drew this eye line a little too high. Make it lower so we'll have more room for the forehead. That's one thing you don't want to do with characters, like when you're working on the face and you don't have enough room for the forehead, that's bad. So let's start here in the middle, towards the middle. And these eyes aren't going to be round. They're kind of similar how I did with my style up here. So you're just gonna go up, cut over. And don't be afraid to let the eyelash stick out. It doesn't have to be so uniform. Actually, you probably want that. I've seen examples of him having the eyelash out there. You wanna really give a face, I mean the sense that this is a face turning. Make it look more three-dimensional. So from here, you're gonna lower lid the eye. You don't really have to close it off. Actually, yeah, let's just leave this section open. We're gonna erase that line from the eye line. Let's draw the pupils or iris. They are pretty circular. From that middle, let's draw a line also for reference. Here is Sharon, Static Shock's sister. We're going to be kind of working off, loosely working off of. So this is like bridge of nose going into eyebrow. You draw that curved line, go retrace it, come up higher. That's gonna work as your eyebrow, shade that in. Let's give her an eyelid. Now for the nose, you're gonna curve back, but you're gonna come down, swallow the line we initially drew. And then cut over in another diagonal. And we're gonna leave that nose right there for now. Now for the other eye, we can go towards the middle. Let's space these out more. Bruce Timm likes to space out his eyes, which is a nice change of pace. We get to get more detail with this eye. It's bigger, easier to work with. So leave that a little ducted right there. And we're gonna put that right there. Gives it a sense that it's looking at the viewer. Eyelid. I remember what I told you before with eyebrows. Just get the shape of what eyebrow you want first. Doing that line. And Bruce Timm's eyebrows are pretty even. Sometimes he has them as just lines, sometimes he thickens them, but they remain pretty consistent throughout. Except the point at the end. So let's not get too carried away with that shading there. playing around. Now the nose, you're going to start the other nostril in the area. Let's, for consistency sake, let's start it right here, go down. You're going to draw little curve nostril. Draw that curve, have it hook. His noses aren't that detailed. Sorry, switching back and forth to my reference. So you draw your nostril, have this little hook right there. And that's going to be good enough for the nose. Let's knock out the ear before the lips. The ear line is just curved line. Hook it. Let's erase that lower jaw. Actually, let's erase a lot of the confusion. So for the lips, let's see, let's bring our reference into here. Let's see, can you all see that? Not the details, so I'll still explain it. Middle point, and then curve it right here. Go back to the middle point. That's how we've been doing lips. Come and just stretch it out. Middle of the eye, right there. You can give your character a frown, smile, that's up to you. We've had enough happy, so let's give a little more serious face, like a Dragon Ball face. The lower lip, diagonal in the opposite direction. This one is gonna be easy, a curve right here. Bring it out and just connect it. Now this is different from sharing because I also have like a step-by-step up on my laptop that you all can't see. That's closer to how Bruce Timm does the other characters. He drew a little different for Static. And I like the black features that he had for Static, but I like the overall style of his other works in the other series a bit better. So we're kind of like combining the two. So now we can start doing the hair. Let's get this hairline up there. Just for reference, he didn't get detailed with the hairline. And plus, if you're drawing like my character, it's gonna get covered up anyway. So, this is the middle where the middle line was. It should faintly still be there. My part is over here. So let's get this shape. I'm gonna leave the forehead out on here. Like I said, I really wanna stress that this is a face turning. So we're gonna leave that there. And from the examples I've seen, looking up pictures of Static, naturals, fros, they're more, it's like lumps, kind of like how the Proud Family style was, but more consistent. Alright, that takes care of the shape of the hair. Let's get rid of the rest of the confusion around here. And there you go with your base design. Now let's hard line and shape. All right, that should do it. Is that a character for disease? The DC animated universe, excuse me. The Bruce Tim universe. That wraps that up. I'll see you in the final video.